All right, so we're talking about surviving in a
zombie apocalypse,
and I should choose the weapon of choice. And then the way it works is like in the World Cup, you have a tournament and you have to choose, and the winner will continue like the World Cup, and the loser is out and the winner will just keep going. So here, for zombie apocalypse, I would choose this one, which is a broken broom, because this, it might look like it's good for zombies, but it's too heavy. It's too heavy and too slow. So if you're like trying to hit zombies, it could be, yeah, a little bit slow, and then your muscle would be too tired.
Ow.
But with the broom, it's very fast, in and out quickly. This is like something that many people like myself, kind of dream about when you're growing up. I actually love zombies. I am a huge zombie fan. In Korea, they're called jombi, but in English, zombie. And I am like a big, big zombie fan. One of my favorite genres. And video games, too. Let's go with the broom. Yay! Why are we cheering? I don't know. Okay, and this is a tough question. These look like camping barbecue sticks. Skewers. In English, that's called a skewer. And a nice set, too, if we have any camping people. I kind of like this one because it seems sharper and better. Like, if you need to, you know, kill some zombies. I also like this one for the same reason. It's speedy, and there's, like, 5 of them. So if you need to, like, put one and then run away, you got 4 more chances to survive. I'm gonna go with the big knife. These ones are a little bit scary because they're so short, so it's very close, up close and personal. And I don't really want to get that close to any zombie. But we'll go with this one. This one is kind of silly. I like this one. I think everyone's gonna get this one, pipe wrench. But the problem is those things are a lot heavier than you expect. So again, you could get a little bit sore with the muscle. The cricket paddle is good for like keeping a distance. Or maybe if you're in a canoe, you can use it to like escape. But I'm not sure if I would be in a canoe. I never played cricket, so I don't know much about cricket, so I don't think I'd be very good with it. Also, that seems too big. And if the zombies are coming in, then you don't have any space to like swing it. So I'm gonna go with the wrench, pipe wrench. Okay, pipe wrench it is. Okay, so here we got a fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher and whatever that is. Is that a sickle? Kind of like a half sickle. I don't know what that's called. I would definitely choose the thing on the right. Fire extinguisher, you have to use 2 hands and it's very heavy. You gotta bash their head with the fire extinguisher. So I think the one-handed thing would be better. You can do the one hand and then another hand. You can like have another weapon. I think fire extinguisher is not good. You could maybe spray them in the face. They don't really care. They're not going to be like, oh, my eyes. So I think fire extinguisher doesn't matter. Even if there's a fire, you're not really going to use it on yourself. So let's go with this one. We got shovels and we got a baseball bat. Well, this one, I believe there is no competition. This one is super, super easy. We are definitely going with the baseball bat. Okay, we can hit home runs off their heads. Baseball bat is very quick, easy to swing, powerful, can do damage. If you had the shovel, you would be using the shovel in the same motion as a baseball bat, only the baseball bat is designed for swinging, and the shovel is not designed for swinging, and it's heavier. So I believe the baseball bat would be much better. Also, the baseball bat, it is designed for hitting something, and the shovel is not. If we get enough people, we can form a whole team. And actually, that is kind of like the fantasy. Not fantasy, but when you think of a zombie apocalypse, you usually think about a team of 4 people. Like, there is an old game which was called Left 4 Dead, and it is a 4-player game for people trying to fight against the zombies. I love that idea. I love the small team, but I kind of feel like I would like a bigger team. Like, how about a team of 10. If that was a video game where there's like 10 people fighting zombies, I think that could be more fun. I mean, it's 2021. Let's have more people. Bow and arrow. Well, this is a simply an easy one for me. Usually in the movies, they usually make the bow and arrow seem really glamorous and awesome. Realistically, I think not many people are good at shooting a bow and arrow, and it takes too much time, and you have to be accurate. I mean, you might be thinking about Legolas from Lord of the Rings, you know, but then you're empty. You have no more. But if you have a pipe, you can swing it forever. Daryl from The Walking Dead. Well, yeah, he's cool, but you know, you have to chase your arrows every time. And what happens when they're coming close? Then you have no choice. You gotta use your arrows like... Okay, sorry for that sound effect. Probably much worse. You're probably screaming like... I can't do that now. I'm in an apartment, and if I start screaming like I'm fighting zombies, I'll probably get a call from the neighbors saying, hey, can you be quiet, please? Okay. This is a tough question because I think both of these are bad choices. Number one, because the first one, this is like a stick almost, and it's not going to do any damage. If you got hit with this, it's not going to be that good. Sledgehammer, way too heavy. Way too heavy. So in this case, I'd probably go with this one just because it's fast. And maybe you could push them away. Okay, so here we have two things. It seems like most people would want to. In this case, everybody would probably think chainsaw. And that's because you probably like movies. I'm specifically thinking of Army of Darkness, Evil Dead, you know, the chainsaw. Or if you're thinking about a video game, you're thinking about Gears of War or Dead Island, or what is that game? I forgot the name of that game. I can't believe I forgot the name. It's an arcade zombie game. With a chainsaw, it is too noisy. Like, okay, zombies are not real, so we don't know. Based on every game and every movie, they usually come to the loud noise, right? We don't know if that's true. Maybe zombies can't hear anything because they're dead. Based on the movies, we don't want to have loud noise, so we'll go with this one. Also, the chainsaw, it's going to run out of gas. If you look very closely here, this almost looks like it's an electric chainsaw, so it almost looks like it needs to be plugged in. Well, that wouldn't work very well. Usually they take gasoline, but I don't see any gasoline part. I had to use a chainsaw a long time ago when I was working construction and landscaping. Sometimes the tree would fall on somebody's land and we have to cut it into many pieces and then move the tree off of their yard. That was a long time ago. Let's go with this one. That police baton or something. I also like that one because you can like snap it out, put it back. So it'd be good for portability. Easy to travel with. I'm gonna go with... These look like good options. I think if I had a team of friends, then I would choose the bamboo because I could just give everybody, hey, here, take this. But I actually think I would go with the golf club. The reason is because the golf club is lightweight. Even older folks can swing the golf club easily. So I believe that, you know, I have a great uncle who's going to be 100 years old and he can still golf. If you can still swing a golf club, then maybe you can defend yourself. But I think bamboo, that looks a little bit cumbersome and difficult to swing. You can really only like stab. I'm gonna go with the golf club. I'm not very good at golf either, but I can still swing it. 100 years old, almost 100 years old. Okay, well, this is an easy answer. Definitely not the gun. Not the gun. For several reasons, because the gun would only be good is because most people are not very good at shooting, and if there's a zombie coming at you like this, you're gonna be like missing, and then he's gonna kill you. So I think the knife would be better, especially a sashimi knife, because these ones are super sharp. It would be like slicing through butter. So you wouldn't need to worry so much about like getting it stuck. Oh, can't get it out. Well, this one's so sharp, I think you could slice right in, right out. I don't know. I'm just thinking. And also, zombies are dead, so zombies probably a little bit decaying. So they probably didn't drink much milk, so probably could be smooth like butter. Exactly. Maybe that's what inspired BTS. Probably not. Probably nobody has ever connected killing zombies with BTS. But we did it today. Good job, you guys. Good job. Life is beautiful. We might be the first people in planet Earth, I should say on planet Earth, to connect BTS with killing zombies. What a connection. I hope they see this. I hope BTS is watching. Obviously, they won't be. But BTS, if you're watching, thank you. Thank you, and tune in for the next one. I'm laughing because that's ridiculous. Okay. This one, we have a slingshot with, it says 50 balls, 50 shots, and we have a hammer. At first, I was thinking, should I go with the hammer? Because hammer seems really easy to swing. I'm a fan of Old Boy. That was one of the very, very first Korean movies that I ever saw, was Old Boy. Old Boy made the hammer famous. And the other thing is, if you're holding the hammer and there are zombies, wouldn't it be awesome to like talk to your friend and be like, it's hammer time, and just go and start hammering zombies in the head? I feel like that would be just a fun thing to do. Fun thing to say with the hammer. Actually, if you're holding a hammer, it is always hammer time. The good thing about the slingshot is you can take rocks. You don't even need the balls. You could pick a stone or something. But the thing is, they're kind of hard to use. I used to have one when I was young. Well, I didn't have one, but my neighbor had one, and we used to play with it. We used to go into his backyard, slingshot buckets, empty buckets, just to see if we could hit them. But let's go with the hammer time. Gotta go with hammer time. Now, this seems like an obvious choice. You probably think you should go with the axe. Actually, this is a hatchet. Axe is longer. This is a hatchet. I'm gonna go with the umbrella because I love the fact it has a handle like a sword and you can put it on your back. And wouldn't that be fun to see some zombie and just grab it like that? The other thing is you can open the umbrella. If it's raining, you can use it for the rain, or you could open it and push them. You know, the outside of the umbrella is very wide. If there's 100 zombies, you could open the umbrella and just run through and they'd be like, boom, 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 pushing off. I don't know how strong this umbrella is though. Or if you need to jump off of some tall place, you can maybe jump and hold on to the umbrella and it can reduce your fall. You probably can't hold on to the middle, but you should hold on to the sides and then maybe you can survive. I'm getting creative here, getting creative. But anyway, with the umbrella, I feel like you can push them away and keep your distance. With the hatchet, you gotta get very close. I don't think it would be smooth like butter. And also, if anybody has ever cut wood, I used to cut wood a lot when I went camping. If you cut wood, your hatchet, it gets stuck. You can't take it out. You hit it and then it's like, oh. So if you hit a zombie, there's a high chance it is going to get stuck, and that's no good. Let's go with the umbrella. Let's go with the umbrella. Okay, we got two things here. This looks like a wooden sword, and this looks like a police baton. I don't like either choice. I don't like either choice. I'll just go with the wooden stick because it's longer. So I feel that these things are both not sharp. They are both made of wood. So the only difference is this one is longer. So for that reason, I'm going to say the longer one because I can keep some distance. If you're facing zombies, you don't want to be close. Let's say this one. Okay, and here we have a brick or a shovel. Well, there's no question here. We're going to go with the shovel because this one is portable, is very lightweight. You can put it in your back pocket or like stick it in your backpack. You don't want to be putting a brick in your pocket or in your backpack. Swinging a brick would be very hard, but swinging a hammer would be very quick and easy. Also, we have a little saw blade here, so it can be useful. Here, if you you need to open a can of food, like a canned food. Usually if there are zombies, it means there was an apocalypse. Because what kind of situation would there be zombies and no apocalypse, right? We need to open canned food. And this right here shows us that we can open the canned food. And if you need to dig something, you can always dig something. Like maybe, sadly, you need to be very primitive. You need to use the bathroom. You are out in the woods. There is no toilet, so you need to dig a hole. This one could be very useful. And then you should cover that hole so that zombies don't find it. I don't know if zombies can smell. Feels like you want to cover that. All right, I don't know what I'm getting into here. Sorry for that. Let's keep it clean. Let's keep it clean. Okay, here we have a Molotov flaming bottle. This is just absolutely the worst thing you could do. Stupid, stupid idea. Because if there is fire, it is also going to kill the zombies and you. You're going to get burned in the fire and by the zombies. And the zombies don't really care about fire. Of course, we don't know what zombies care about. From popular culture, we would assume that zombies don't really care about fire. What would be worse than a lot of zombies attacking you? Well, a lot of flaming zombies attacking you. That would be worse. Okay, so not only are you getting attacked by zombies, but you're getting attacked by flaming zombies. So I'm gonna say, why would anybody choose this? I'm really curious, who would choose this? I want to find someone on YouTube who took the same test and chose this. I want to hear, why did you choose this one? I'd definitely be open for a friendly debate, but we'll go with a crowbar. Crowbar, very useful. You can enter some building or a car or anything. Yeah, this one would be good. Now, flaming zombies are a thing. Flaming zombies are a thing. Have I been watching a lot of zombie films recently? No, I haven't, but I love zombie films. So for now, I'm going to choose the crowbar. Crowbar. Oh, okay. Well, I really don't like both of these ones. This one, I feel like if you're using this one and you hit the zombie, it's going to get stuck. I feel like you can't get it out. So let's go with the hiking one. Because again, we can push them away. So I'm gonna go with this. Okay, so now we have, what is this? I think it's like a police baton and this is like a crowbar. So I feel like this one is not good because the end point is quite narrow and small. And if we're talking about zombies, I believe you're not hitting them. They wouldn't even get hurt. You actually need to destroy them. So I'm gonna say crowbar would be better for that because the weight is on the head. So this could do some damage. This one, I don't think it would be. It would just be good for like hitting them. I think this one's better. Even though it's a little bit heavier, I think this one could be more effective. Okay, I'm gonna go with the crowbar again. I think crowbar is just more useful overall. We'll go with crowbar. I have a feeling crowbar is gonna win a lot. Not sure, but I'm just guessing. Well, here I'm gonna go with the hammer. I just feel like the hammer way more useful. Very versatile. It can be a tool, but it can also do damage. With this, it's too big to carry. And what can you do with it, really? So hammer. Plus, as you know, I just want to scream hammer time every time I use it. Every time I swing the hammer, I'm going to say hammer time. And the people who are surviving together with me, they are going to be so tired of me saying hammer time. They might just hide the hammer and put one of these here instead. Here, I'm going to go with a broom, a broken broom, broken mop, I should say. That's a mop. Broken mop, I feel like it's much faster, has a sharper edge. With this stick, I don't believe it's very powerful. Not really good for zombies. This, I believe, could do more damage overall. Okay, this is a tough one because I really do like this pipe wrench, but I feel like the crowbar can achieve the same thing as the pipe wrench. Not pipe wrench. Pipe. I believe these are basically the same, only the difference is this is an actual tool and could come in handy and could be very useful, whereas I believe this only has one purpose. And here I do love the umbrella because it has the handle, and again, you can open the umbrella and run through a crowd of zombies. You can put it on your back and just make a cool motion, but I believe that the military shovel would be way better. Here we even have a can opener here. We have a little saw here. As much as I love the umbrella, we'll go with the shovel. I don't really like both of these, but I'm gonna go with this one because I feel like this can be more useful. It's not gonna get stuck if you hit something with it. I don't think it's gonna get stuck. And it comes with a nice case. I didn't mention this before, but it comes with a nice case. So if you find a belt, I'm sure you can find a belt. It looks like you can put it on your belt, and then that would be much easier. This one, it seems like it'll get stuck and not very useful. Here, you can use this for almost anything. So we're gonna go with this one. Here we have a sashimi knife and a hiking pole. So again, I believe we're gonna go with the sashimi knife because it cuts through things smooth like butter. Again, the BTS connection with the sashimi knife. BTS, if you're watching, thank you, and I hope you appreciate this connection there. There are a lot of BTS fans watching. I am anyway, and we have at least one here. Okay, so here we have baseball versus golf, and I believe these are two sports. It's kind of funny that zombie apocalypse is almost like a sporting event because usually sports equipment works well for some reason. Okay, we're gonna go with the baseball bat just because I feel like the baseball bat is a little bit more durable, and I feel like the golf club could get bent in the middle. Okay, well, I think both of these are pretty good choices. I think they both achieve the same goal because you're both swinging it. I think the golf club, you can swing a little bit faster, and the golf club, so golf club wins when it comes to speed, and it also wins when it comes to portability because it's easier to carry, and also it's longer, so it's better for distance. But I believe for me personally, I'm gonna go with the baseball bat because I feel like it's a little bit stronger and I feel like you can hit more zombies with it. So I think they're both good choices. Okay, again, I think you guys know my answer. Hammer, yeah, good job. It is the hammer. The reason is because I told you I just wanna scream hammer time every time I use it. I mean, wouldn't that be ridiculous if you were walking in a zombie apocalypse and you saw some guy screaming hammer time, hitting people, hitting zombies with a hammer. It's like Leroy Jenkins when he screamed his own name. All right, this is a tough one because I like both of these. They're both tools, they're both multifunctional. They're both useful. I believe that the function is similar. I think this one has more distance and this is more durable. This one can also open a can of food, probably. This one has a food opener, a can opener. This one has a saw, which is really, really useful. But I think if I'm thinking about zombies only, I'm gonna go with the crowbar. Am I making a mistake? I think they're both good, but I feel like crowbar could be better. Let's go with crowbar. Okay, for this one, this is also tough. I like the fact that this one has a carrying case, so you could put that on your belt. And with a sharp object, there are usually multiple uses with it. Like you could use this for cutting things, like cutting a rope or even opening a can. But I feel like if I'm fighting zombies, I would actually rather have a bat. I feel like this one would be way better for survival, but if we're just thinking about zombies only, I feel like the bat would be more effective because you can swing it much, has more distance between you and the zombie. I'm not sure. It is a tough choice, and I am in a serious dilemma because if you're thinking about a zombie apocalypse, you gotta make a quick decision. What am I gonna grab? Okay, I think if the zombie's coming and I just gotta grab one thing, I think I'm gonna grab this bat. Yeah, I'm gonna grab the bat. Also, because if I grab the bat, if I grab the knife, maybe it's stuck. Maybe it's stuck in my belt and I can't like undo it and the zombie's coming. No! Okay, I don't know. I'm getting a little crazy here. Like I said, it's the second coffee. Maybe that's the reason. No question. We're going with a sashimi knife. I think that's a lot. I think everyone, no question. Okay, wow. All right, this is a really tough one. But my instinct is telling me crowbar. My instinct is telling me crowbar, but thing is, I don't know. I mean, if you find some fish or something, then you could have sashimi. So you can't really make sashimi with a crowbar. That would be a very rough sashimi. Grab it and eat it with your teeth. We're going with a crowbar, so that sushi will not look that pretty. Oh, wow. Wow, what should we do here? Are we going to go with hammer time or are we going to go with a baseball bat? Hammer time or baseball bat? I really want to scream hammer time. But here, you could say, if you had the baseball bat, what could you scream when you're running at the zombie? I think you could scream batter up. But batter up doesn't really feel the same as screaming hammer time, does it? I'm going to go with the hammer because I think the hammer, even though it's shorter, I feel like you can use it for multiple purposes, but the baseball bat, only two purposes, hitting things and playing baseball. So we're going to go with the hammer. And hammer time has the catchphrase. Oh, wow. I didn't think this quiz would be this difficult, but this is difficult. Both tools, by the way, these are both tools. Is the scream necessary? Yes, absolutely the scream is necessary because think about when you're in war. If you watch old movies, they're always screaming on the battlefield like, rah! There's a new game called Chivalry 2, which I would love to play. And the funnest part is screaming in battle. That's why they call a war cry or a battle cry. And if you're in battle and you're screaming, it makes them scared. Maybe it would make more zombies come, which could be a bad thing. So if you're screaming hammer time, well, then maybe the other zombies are like, huh? And they start coming. So maybe that's a bad thing. All right, well, what do we want? Crowbar or hammer? I feel like these two tools, let's think about this logically. What's the difference between the crowbar and the hammer? I believe they serve the same purpose. If you think about the back of the hammer, it is essentially the same thing as this part and this part. So as a tool, it does the same thing. This is made out of wood. This wood could actually break. And this is made out of steel. And this steel would never break. You could not break this. So I feel like as a tool, this is better. It's longer, so you have more range, so you can keep more distance. And if you needed to hammer something, you could still hit the nail. Even though it is not a hammer, I think you could still scream hammer time. Somebody might look at you and think, wow, that guy's weird. He's screaming hammer time, and he's using a crowbar, not a hammer. It's kind of like a risk that I'd be willing to take. So even though it's a crowbar, I could still scream hammer time and people might think I'm weird, but I guess I can live with that. It's an apocalypse after all. We're going with crowbar. Crowbar, yay! It's the crowbar. I don't know what this says. I don't know what all this says, but we went with the crowbar.